Today, Malaysia is 51 years old. Last year, we celebrated the Golden Jubilee of Malaysia. A greater portion of the Malaysian population, particularly in Sabah and Sarawak, who made Malaysia possible, they are not happy. They are disappointed. Why are we disappointed? Why are we not happy? Because for the last 50 years, we realize that we have moved from being a colony, especially Sabah, back a full circle back to a colony. According to the Kabul Commission, it is a necessary condition that from the outset, from the beginning, Malaysia should be regarded by all concerned as association of partners, combining in the common interest to create a new nation, but retaining their own individuality. Kabul Commission Chairman also warned, give a warning. He said, if any idea was to take root, that Malaysia would involve a takeover of the Borneo territories by the Federation of Malaya and the submission of their individualities of Sabah and Sarawak, Malaysia would not, in my judgment, be acceptable or successful. This is, we were downgraded from a partner to become, from one of four to become one of 13. In terms of parliamentary representation, lihat, in 1963, there was this understanding that the terms kita punya kepentingan will be protected because Malaya will only have two-thirds of the, not up to two-thirds of the parliamentary seats. Today, this one, 204, they already control more than two-thirds, 74% of the parliamentary seat they already control. Let me go through this expectation versus reality. How much of the basis for us to be in Malaysia have been implemented? I put a scale of 1 to 5. Kalau 1, 2 are implemented. Kalau 4, 5 not implemented, not fulfilled. Okay, so Malaysia Agreement, there is a 5. Means it's not consummated. Okay? Number 2, equal partner, not state number 12 or 13, Manada. Masih lagi, we are 12 and 13, so is partnership is not implemented. Okay? 20 points. Has it been implemented or breached? No state religion in Sarawak still hold, I think. Huh? In Sabah, it's 4 now because partly salah kita punya pemimpin sendiri during the Mustafa Harris time. Language already breached. All this meaning that the kita punya asas-asas dalam Malaysia sudah tidak ada sudah. So now people are not happy. And they are not happy and they call for a review. Because now the cost and benefit is mostly cost. Loss of autonomy, loss of our political franchise. They lost. Loss of our oil resources. Loss of our legitimate role in the federation. Because any federation is supposed to be a shared federation. But now, where is the sharing of the role of Sabah and Sarawak in the federation? It's mostly Malaya controlling the federation, running the federation. Kita ni siring-siring saja. Betul ke tidak? So it's a loss to us. Loss of job opportunities, no bonionization. Loss of religious freedom. Loss of dignity, loss of independence, loss of opportunity to be like Singapore or Brunei. That is a lost opportunity. Betul kata tidak? So, this all cost to us. So, we want to resolve this. How did we lose? The plot. Kenapa kita begini? Kenapa kita sekarang complain? First of all, because we were too trusting. We trusted Britain and Malaya. We gave them too much respect. But at that time, you know, we were not ready. According to the Kabul Commission report, Sarawak 10 tahun belum lagi bersedia. Apalagi Sabah. Sabah 20 years. You require 20 years. Baru ready politically. And we were really not ready at that time. Why? Well, you know lah. You, Tun Mustafa, Tun Fuad, Tun Mustafa, only primary 2, primary 3, mau negotiate sama Tun Razak, sama Lee Kuan Yew, macam mana? So now, we are complaining, what are we going to do about it? Going back to the present, we are experiencing all this, what are we going to do? I think we have to make a stand. The present generation have to make a stand. What we are going to do? There are three options. Three options. One, do nothing. Just tolerate. Accept sajalah. Apa boleh buat? Ini nasib kita sudah. Tidak boleh buat apa-apa. Suffer, suffer lah. This is one option. Do nothing. Accept. Are you going to do nothing? Okay. Second option, you get out. They don't do anything, you want to get out. Okay lah, kalau begini you don't want to solve the problem, we get out. Might be a better option, yeah? Because you don't solve the problem, we get out lah. You have no problem, I have no problem. But you think they will allow you to do that? You have to think about it. And the third one is, come on lah, sit down. We solve this problem. Okay? Solve this problem. We sit down. And that is the third option. You think about what option is best for us, best for Sarawak. One, two, or three. Sabah and Sarawak got the opportunity, the power to push the federal government to agree to come to a solution. But only if they are united. Sabah and Sarawak must sit down together. And if they are united, I think we can resolve it. So better resolve this while you can, because if this is not resolved, there may be more than a political revolution coming up. You don't want to come to that. Sekian. Terima kasih.